Thanks for this introduction. So I'm a PhD student with Telecom Paritech and Thales. I present a paper about extra reduction in Montgomery modular multiplication to attack blinding regular algorithm. So to begin, first I present Montgomery modular multiplication and the Montgomery extra reduction. The extra reduction is the final subtraction in Montgomery modular multiplication. I present the state of the art of the attack against extra reduction, like a timing attack. And second, our contribution is the new idea of the attack and the information given by extra reduction. And to conclude, I finish a part with experimental results on a software library. So to begin, the modular exponentiation in RSA, the private operation, and you have an exponent k. This is the secret. And we just make the message to raise power k modulo p. So to make this modular exponentiation, we make a lot of modular multiplication. And all this multiplication can be optimized to have an efficient compute. And we have computation. And we have we have several algorithms to make this Montgomery modular multiplication, or Barrett, or something like this to be efficient. So to be clear with the notation, we use the Montgomery modular multiplication with R, the smaller power of 2 greater than P. To have the number, and all the integer is transformed by Montgomery transformation, and all the integer is include 0 and p. And to make the modular multiplication, we just multiply the Montgomery form of a by the Montgomery form of b, using the inverse of R, the inverse of R modulo P. So to make this computation, we just make the multiply of the two Montgomery form, and after we reduce using an algorithm like this. And so it just multiply by the inverse of R, and without just using a modular reduction by R and divided by R. R is a power of 2, so it's efficient to make this compute at the line 1 and line 2. And the U value, no, for to the pointer. So just the u value is it's including 0 and n to p. And to have the result between 0 and p, we just make an extra reduction. So it's a line 4. This extra reduction is defined by the x value, and is when you don't have an extra reduction, the x value equals 0. So how to find the extra reduction? So several implementation in software. We have some code, example code, to find this extra reduction. So OpenSSL use Montgomery modular multiplication in RSA. And we use the comparison with the modular name mont n is the p in my presentation. And if we have greater than p, you have an extra reduction. So we have a conditional finite strip reduction. It depends in timing. We can see this extra reduction. In Embed TLS, another software library, we have an extra reduction and a fake extra reduction to prevent timing attack, like a comment write. And this is possible to find when we have a real extra reduction or a fake extra reduction. So for experiment, in OpenSSL, we have implemented in Cortex M0, and we have compute the spectrogram of the power consumption traces. And the spectrogram is the time in the vertical line, and we have the frequency in the X line axis. And we have a square and a multiply and another square. And when we don't have any space, we don't have a final strip reduction. And here, we have more timing between the operation, and we have an extra reduction. The second experimental part is electromagnetic analysis on Embed TLS implemented in Cortex M4. So it's just all the acquisition on RSA. Just one modular exponentiation. And for the extra reduction, you just cut all the operations, square and multiply, and you look the part of the extra of the traces to find if a real or dummy extra reduction. So just using your eyes, you cannot find the difference. But using an horizontal side-channel analysis like clustering or something like this, you can find a difference between the x equals 1 and the x equals 0. So the first attack to using the timing is by Kosha. So it's a global timing attack. We choose, a message. You create a template for the time, and we find what is the exponent. For this, we can know the modulus, so we have no CRT. But we want to find an attack using unknown p. So we regarding the attack like by Schindler. So we have a lot of attack by Schindler during all of this 15 years old. So the second is Schindler 1 and Schindler 2 is an attack using a choosing message. So Schindler make an input small or big, and he decide if we have an extra reduction or not, and using the global timing, we can find the exponent. The last year at CHEST, at Saint-Malo, he published an attack against blinding exponent using this choosing message. So the question is it possible to have an attack against a regular algorithm and against without a choosing message? So the Schindler 4 is an attack against no SPA protect simple power analysis protect attack, and we find a difference between square and multiply. So using the extra reduction, and not all the global timing, but a local timing, we can have a difference between have an extra reduction in multiply and have an extra reduction in a square. So this difference can be find the square and multiply operation in modular exponentiation. So how it works? So you make a set of acquisition. You have a different message, M0, M2, M4. You cut all the operation, and you remark if you have an extra reduction or not for each operation. So for the first message, for the first operation, operation 0, we have an extra reduction after the operation square or multiply. The second operation, operation 1, for the message M, we don't have an extra reduction. So the x equals 0. You make for all the operation and for all the acquisition this part, and you deduce, you compute the mean of each extra reduction, and you have the estimated probability of each operation. So to be clear, I wrote another algorithm. So for each operation and for each acquisition, you detect the extra reduction, x equals 1 or x equals 0. And after, you compute the mean. And you have the estimated probability using histogram method. And just using this method, you have something near to pi divided by 4r for the first operation. For when the key bit value equals 1, we have pi divided by 4r. So it's a multiply, and after the second operation is the third operation is a square, and the fourth operation is against the square because you have something like p divided by 4 here. So it's a principle for Chandler 4 attack. So to sum up, Kosher and Schindler 1 and Schindler 2 use the choosing message. So to protect against this attack, you just blind the message. And the Schindler 4 is just find the difference between square and multiply. So if you use an algorithm like square and multiply always, or Montgomery ladder, or something like this, you are protected against Schindler 4. So So how to break this algorithm? So in this talk, I present the attack against square and multiply arrays, but in the paper, we have the part against Montgomery ladder. So the blinding square and multiply arrays, left to right, is just you blind the message, and after you make a for loop for all the bit value of k, and you have a square, and we have a multiply for all the loop value, and we have we name the operation si and mi. So for the first operation, the probability to have an extra reduction in the square is p divided by 4r, and for a multiply is p divided by for square is p divided by 3r, and for m is p divided by 4r. And for the second bit, when the bit is 0, we have all the time the dummy multiplication, and this dummy multiplication have the same propagation for extra reduction, so is the same probability. So we cannot distinguish if we have a 1 or a 0 bit value. So when you study two consecutive operations, we want to study two consecutive operations, and if the operation are independent, we have just the multiplication of the two probability, to this. So we want to analyze this. Is it work or not? But the probability find is something like this. So when a bit value is 1, the output of the multiply is the input of the square. So the probability to have two extra consecutive extra reduction is low. And when the key bit value is 0, the input of the multiply is the input of the square. So the probability is higher than previous. So how to find this probability and this the joint probability against operation. So we have studied the distribution of the output multiplication, modular multiplication. So when you multiply two random values between uniformly distributed in ZOP, the distribution is the uniform, the multiplied distribution is uniform. And the mean of the value is p divided by 2. So when you study we have the absence of extra reduction, x equals 0, we have the output distribution increase, and we have something like this. So the probability to have a number without extra reduction, the number is bigger than previous. If we have an extra reduction, we have the blue curve, and the blue is the distribution decrease, and the value is small when you have an extra reduction. So the observation is when you have the key bit value equals 1, you have as an input the random value and the message blinding, so another random value as an input of the multiplication. If we observe an extra reduction, for the multiply, when the key value is 1, the output of the multiply is the input of the square. When you observe an extra reduction, the output is small. So the input of the square, we don't have a chance to, we is a small probability to have two extra reductions consecutive. If the bit value is 0, the random value is the input of the multiply, and if the input of the square. And when you have an extra reduction, the probability to have two extra reductions between the multiply and the next square is higher than the previous. So the work writes a beautiful theorem with this probability computation. And to be clear, I just make an example. When I go an example with a p close to r, we have just something like this. And for the key value equals 1, we have 1 divided by 48 to have two consecutive extra reductions between the multiply and the next square. And when the key bit value is 0, we have something like the 6 divided by 48. So just using the Pearson correlation, using the joint probability of the theorem, we have something like this. When the ratio p divided by r increase, the correlation decrease when the key bit value equals 1. And when the qubit value equals 0, we have the positive value. So how to exploit these means? We have the same as the beginning. So we cut all the operation and we detect each extra reduction between the consecutive operation multiply and square. And we compute the estimate correlation Pearson. So we have this for all the operation and for all the acquisition. We compute the probability and after we compute the Pearson correlation coefficient. So to exploit these bias, we have make a simulation to find how the number of queries to make the acquisition. And as you can see, when we have the positive value of the qubit value equals 0, and when we have negative Pearson correlation value, we have the qubit value equals 1. So to make this compute, we have estimated the number of traces when we have a failure rate of the detection in extra reduction. And we just add a noise in the simulation traces. And we have run a noise of 10% to have a failure rate. The number of traces is 300 traces. And when you have increased the probability of noise, you increase the number of traces, but it's reasonable. So for the experiment we have made in OpenSSL with timing detection, we have no noise in the detection, so the number of queries is 200. For MBTLS, using a different method of horizontal side channel analysis, the number of queries to make the attack is 10,000. So to conclude, so we have found a new attack against the chainless remainder theorem without choosing message. And when we have a simple power analysis protect, the future work maybe is when you blind when you have a protection against a key. We have a detail for Montgomery ladder in the paper. Thanks for your attention. Do you have any questions?